What's going on, everybody? It's Bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about inner classes in Java. Yes, it is legal to have classes inside of other classes. Let's get into it. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Hey everyone, we're going to be discussing inner classes. What this is that an inner class is basically a class inside of another class. It's kind of like that lesson on nested loops, how you can have loops inside of other loops, but in this case, you can also have classes inside of other classes, and this is useful if an inner class should be limited in its scope. They're usually set to private, but that's not always necessary. And one of the reasons that we use inner classes is because it helps group classes that belong together. And I would say that this is extremely useful for listeners for handling specific events. And I would say that this is a necessary lesson when we move on to the next video on anonymous inner classes, where we're actually going to be creating some customized action listeners. So let's begin. We have a main class here. Let's also create another class. So I'm going to click on my source folder, go to File, New, Class, and let's call this class Outside. And then click Finish. And then within our class Outside, we're going to create another class. We'll make it public, but we don't have to. Public class, and we'll call this next class Inside. The Inside class is going to be inside of the Outside class. Now let's assign some variables. So how about we create a string, string x equals the word hello, and I'll add a space after this. And we'll also create a variable within our inside class. We'll call this string y equals world. Now going back to our main class, we can instantiate an instance of our outside class and our inside class. But let's begin with our outside class. So we'll type the name of the class, outside, and we'll call this instance, just out, equals new outside. All right, so we have an instance of our outside class, and it's called out. Now we can also instantiate an instance of the inside class, the inner class of the outside class. And in order to do this, this is what we're gonna do. We first need to type in the name of the outside class that's acting as the container. So we're going to type outside dot and then the name of the inner class. And it's actually right here if you have IntelliSense set up. So outside dot inside, which is the name of the inner class. And we will call this instance maybe in equals, then type in the name of the instance of the outer class, out dot new, then the name of the inner class again, inside parentheses semicolon. So now what we have here is an instance of the outside class, out, and an instance of the inner class, in. So let's actually access these variables, x and y. So we're going to put these within a println statement. So we're going to type system.out.println. If we want to access x, what we're going to type is the name of the instance of the outside class. So that's out dot x. Then we'll add plus. Then now we want to access this y variable, which is in the inner class. So what we're going to type here is the name of the instance of the inner class, so in dot y. So now if we were to run this, it displays hello world. Now we can actually access a method from an inner class. So let's create a greeting method. So we'll make this public, public void greeting. And all we'll do here is display our print line statement. So I'm going to copy this and move it. And then we can get rid of out dot and in dot. We can just display X and Y. So let's try this again. And this time we actually need to call the method of the inside class. So we're going to type in the name of the inside class, which is in dot, and use the greeting function that we just made. And if we were to run this, we can now access a method that's inside of an inner class. All right, well, that's the basics of inner classes. And in the next video, we're going to discuss anonymous inner classes, which are extremely useful for listeners for handling specific events. But yeah, that's the basics of inner classes in Java. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me.
help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.